The task force looking into the disappearance of Lisa Irwin has shut down its command post. That's because the leads are drying up, but some leads remain from unconventional sources. Peggy Breit is live now with the story from the Irwin's Northland home. Peggy?
Kelly, police and FBI say they've done all they can with what they've gotten in terms of information about Lisa's disappearance from their home year the night of October 3rd. As tips have dried up, psychics have come up with their own theories.
Hello.
On the other end of the phone line is psychic Stephanie Almaguer of Dallas, Texas. She's on medical leave from her job as a school security officer, which has given her time to focus on the story of Kansas City's missing child, Lisa Irwin.
As crazy as it sounds, I see things. I see like visions, and I, you know, get feelings and I hear things, and I believe that an accident happened in the home.
Stephanie has been posting on a blog since the day Lisa vanished, October 4th, and she drew things she says she saw in her visions, came up with names of people who turned out to be connected to the case. Kansas Cityans who saw her blog said they think Stephanie is referring to this area around the old Samstown Casino, within a couple miles of the Irwin home.
These bloggers saying, "You described this place exactly. How, you know, how did you do that?" Well, I don't know how I did it, but if it fits, search it.
So the Kansas Cityans have organized a search of the area for this Saturday. Police won't be involved, but they will be called if anyone finds anything, and Stephanie will be notified.
I'm not in it for anything but to find Lisa.
Now, that community search is set for 9 o'clock on Saturday morning. We'll let you know what happens. We're live at 36th and North Lister. Back to you in the studio, Kelly.
All right. Thank you, Peggy. Now, police say that tips like this one from a psychic are like many that they've received so far, but that it's really too vague to follow. But they still want any specific tips, so you should call the tips hotline if you think you can help.